Good morning, students. Today we are going to start with our subject computer of class 5th, chapter number 7, starting Excel 2013. Excel is a program that helps in calculation and in analyzing data using the formula and tables. You can display the data in a number of ways in Excel and also create graphs and charts. Excel is the most popular program for calculating now these days. The first such program was the BasicCAD, which was released in the 1979. Excel is a part of your Microsoft Office package. So let's start with the Excel. To start the Excel, first you have to click on All Program. Then click on Microsoft Office 2013. Or you can see here, we have most used app, so that is Excel. Select the app. So this is a starting window of your Excel software. You can click on New button to start a new. Here, the first one is blank Excel worksheet will appear. A worksheet is a page containing the grids of cell made up of rows and columns. Select blank worksheet. So here we have a different cells which are subdivided as a part of rows. These are named as rows and these are named as column. The vertical bars are named as column and the horizontal bars are named as rows. So let's discuss the parts of Excel window. So the first, the quick access toolbar. The quick access toolbar is made to give you the quick access to the commands you use often. By default, it includes save command, undo and redo command. You can add more command of your choice by clicking on this drop menu and select a command which you want to add. For example, print preview. So it's added into your quick access toolbar. Then we have a title bar. The title bar is located at the top. It displays the name of workbook in which you are currently working. So we are currently working in a book number 1. So this is a title bar. A workbook is a collection of worksheet. The right side of title bar contains the three buttons, minimize, maximize and the close button. And along with this, here you can check the information through which you have signed your Excel software. So this option is available if you have buy the original Microsoft Office package. Then below the title bar, here we have a ribbon. The ribbon contains the commands required to perform the various tasks like formatting, sorting, etc. It has a number of tabs, each divided into subgroups. Each group consists of many of command. So some group have a small arrows. So like these arrows at the bottom of right corner, this is a dialog box launcher. Clicking on this arrow, it will open the dialog box in which you have seen the some more commands available in that group. So as we select the dialog box of font group, so you can see here the more commands are related to the fonts are here. Using this dialog box, you can customize your font mode. Scroll bar. The scroll bar appears only if you have data more than the screen can be displayed at once. There are two scroll bars. One is vertical scroll bar on the right and the horizontal scroll bar at the bottom. To scroll one cell at a time, click the scroll buttons with the arrows at the corner of scroll bars. To scroll more, drag the slider up and down, left and right in the scroll bar. Status bar. The status bar is present at the bottom of window, which display the following. First one is work view options. First is normal view. By default, a worksheet open in a normal view. This view shows you all the rows and columns in worksheet. Second is page layout view. It divides your worksheet into a pages. Page number 1, page number 2. Third is page break view. It gives you an overview of worksheet with the page break view and tells you how many printed pages would be required to hold all the data in worksheet. You can adjust the page break to increase or decrease the number of pages that will hold your data. So we have a blank sheet, so there is no page number. Next is zoom control. So let's type some information. For example, 20. Now come to the zoom. Here we can increase the zoom. So like just to the view of your information. It does not affect on the word that you have written. So if you take the printout, so it is according to the font formatting that you have done through the font dialog box. It is just for the soft content if you want to increase or decrease the view of your content. Next is active workbook. The Excel files are called the workbooks. Each workbook holds one or more worksheet, and active workbook accepts entire and the commas. So here we have one worksheet. So if we add more than one, so as you select the sheet, you can see the data of that sheet. So here we have worksheet tabs. So clicking on this plus symbol, you can add more worksheet to your Excel workbook. Next is rows and columns. A worksheet in Excel has 1048576 rows and total 16384 columns. The rows are numbers from top to bottom along the left edge as 1, 2, 3, 4, so on. So as you select, this is a one row. The columns are labeled from left to right using the letters of alphabet. The first column is A, second is B, and so on until Z. So next numbering is starting with A and A. Cell. A cell is the smallest unit of worksheet formed by intersection of rows and column. Each cell has a unique address formed by the combination of column letter and the row number. So this is a one cell. The second cell. So as you can see, the address of this cell is C4. The alphabet of column, that is C, and row number, that is 4. So the address of this column is C4. You can check the address in address bar. So as you select this column, so that is D2. So the address is D2. So the cell which you select, that is named as active cell. And if you type some information from your keyboard, that is typed in active cell always. For example, if I press 47 from my keyboard, so that is pressed typed in cell D4, that is our active cell. Then formula bar. The formula bar display the data or formula used in the formula bar display the data or the formula used in the selected cell. It is also used for entering or editing the cell content. Name box is present at the left of the formula bar. It displays the address of selected cell. So this is name box. And this one we have a formula bar where we can type the value of active cell or either we can type the formulas. Next is data types. You can enter the three types of data in Excel worksheet. One is numbers, second is text, and third is formulas. So let's learn how to enter a data in your Excel worksheet. The data is entered simply by selecting a cell and by typing. As you type the data in the field in the formula bar and in the active cell at the same time, the formula bar is located just below the ribbon and display the data or the formula stored in active cell. It can be used to enter or edit the data in the or formula in a cell. So we are on sheet number 1. So just select the cell A2. So we can enter the three type of a data. One is text. For example, name, class, and we have a marks of subject like English, Punjabi, Hindi, computer. Here we can type the student's name like Arman, Dinesh, type their class like 5th class, marks in English like 78, in Punjabi he got 89, in Hindi he got 67, in a computer he got 87. Dinesh in English like 68, in Punjabi like 72, in Hindi like 77, in computer like 74. So in this we have name of students in the form of text. This all the information like class, subject, English, Punjabi, Hindi and computer written in the form of text. These are the number data. So as you type some information in an active cell that you can see in your formula bar, you can click on formula bar to edit this information. For example, 66. So as you change the value in formula bar, the same value will be changed in your active cell. So it's changed from 77 to 66. So as you select the active cell, so when you change any value like 74, here you can see the two buttons. The first one is cancel button and can be used to cancel the data entry without pressing the delete. So it will make the change back to the previous one. The second button is used to enter the button. By clicking on this, it will enter the new value into the cell. And third one is FX, is called the insert function button. It is used to insert the function in your Excel sheet. The use of this button will be discussed in the higher classes. So just for example, we need to calculate the total here. So we type the formula to get the total of these marks in this column. So we type the formula in this formula bar. for example, sum 3 colon F3. So as we typing this formula, so when we click on this insert enter button, so it will applicate. So it will get the total of from this cell to this cell value. So we change the class into the Roman letter, so it's easy for us. So here is the total of Arman marks, that is 321. This is the total of Dinesh marks, is the 282. Creating a new workbook. By default, a workbook opens only a one sheet and it can contain a maximum up to 225 worksheets. Click the File tab in the screen appears. So you can, after doing your work, you can save your work on your computer that we will discuss in this session after some time. So click on File tab, select the new, click on a blank worksheet. A blank worksheet will appear on your desktop. Next is saving a workbook. The steps to save your workbook. First of all, you have to click on File tab. Select Save option. If you want to save the workbook with the existing name, click the Save As. If you wish to save your workbook for the first time or save the workbook with the new name. So if you want to wish the same file in another folder or with another name, then you can use Save As command. So click on Browse command, Browse button. So new dialog box will appear. Browse to the folder where you wish to save your file. So you can select any folder. Then in a file name, type the name of your file. For example, class 5th Excel. Click on save button to save your file. So your Excel files always save with the extension XLSX. So you can save your file. So you need to select any another folder which you have a permission to save your file. So select and save it. Next is selecting cells. Some operations, for example, to make the text bold, color text, copy paste cell data, etc. You need to perform on a range of cells. So range is a rectangular box or the continuous cells. The continuous means the cell touch each other, especially along a line. Before performing any operation on a range cell, you need to select a range. So there are three ways to select a range. First is using a mouse. To select the range of a cell using the mouse, click on a cell from which you want to start. Then hold your left button of your mouse and drag the mouse over the another cells which you want to select. And release your button of mouse. So it will select that information. The second is using the extended mode. When the cell range or cell to be selected in a large, dragging the mouse through the entire range can be cumbersome. In a such case, a click on the corner of starting cells . Now press F8, the status bar shows the extension selection mode, so click the diagonally options. And the last cell of range, the range will be selected. Third one is using the Go command, or either with the help of keyboard, you can select with the Shift key. So select the first cell, then press the Shift key and select the last cell which you want to select. So you can select with the Shift key also. Third is using the Go command. Click the cell at the one corner of the range. Click on a Home tab and the editing group. Click Find and Select. Click Go to and type the cell reference of opposite corner of the range. For example, that is G4. Click on OK button. In case, hold down the shift key when clicking on OK or press the enter. So in this way, you can select with the help of using the Go command. Next is selecting multiple ranges simultaneously. To select the range, do the following. Select the first range of cell. For example, we want to select the name and class. Press the hold key. Select the another range of cell. For example, total. So with the mouse, you can select the another cells. Selecting the complete row or column. To select the complete row, click on row heading. To select the complete column, click on column heading. For example, we want to select the Arman rows, so click on row number 3. If you want to select the total column, then click on column alphabet, that is G. To select the entire row or a column. If you wish to select the entire worksheet, to select the entire worksheet, click on a blank button on the top left corner. So that is the intersection of rows and column to select your entire sheet. So then after this, after selecting all the data, then you can apply some font formatting and the other features of Excel that we are going to discuss in your next chapter. So in this session, we have discussed about the worksheet. Each page of the worksheet containing a grid of cells made up of rows and column. Workbook, a collection of worksheet. Cell, the smallest unit of worksheet formed by the intersection of rows and column. A cell pointer, highlighted cell, a boundary that specifies which cell is active at the moment. Range, a rectangular box of the continuous cell. Continuous means connecting or touching especially along a line, all the cells. Okay students, now you have to do all the question answers on your notebook and the book work on your book. Thank you. Have a nice day.